Welcome back, friends. The next task is how to use GeoGebra to check the properties of a regular polygon. Let us try to check some very important properties one after the other. Here what we are going to do is we are not going to draw regular polygons separately. We making use of the slider, we are going to get all the regular polygons one after the other. For example, we are going to get the equilateral triangle, square, pentagon, hexagon and so on by simply making use of the sliders. For that, first let us start with the slider. Slider is over here. Let me click this slider over here. Then it's what should be its minimum number for a regular polygon. It should be 3. The maximum, let us have anything you can have, let us have it as 10. And let us call its increment as 1. Okay. When I move this, A is equal to 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, I will get the regular polygon of that particular side. Okay, I will keep it over here. Let me take this polygon, go to this regular polygon. Now I want to start the regular polygon. Now, when I put this option, let me go for labeling of new points only. It is already there. Labeling of new points is there. Well, okay. Let us go to this regular polygon. Let me start with A, then immediately this is the length we are fixing. This is B, immediately it will ask how many sides. This side I am going to have going on changing, therefore I will call it as small a, okay. Now you got a equilateral triangle now. Let me make the triangle little bit straight and then B, okay. What will happen now when I move this? I will get a square, a pentagon, hexagon and so on to this. Okay, well, let us try to check the property one after the other. Okay, let us try to check the properties one after the other. Four, five, six, seven, so on. First, let us see the property of angles. Angle, simply when I click it, all the angles are 60 degrees. What's the first property for regular polygons? All the interior angles are equal, and the formula for it is 2n minus 4 upon n multiplied by 90 degrees. For when you go to square, it is 90. For pentagon, it is 108. For hexagon, it is 120. And for having 7 sides, it is 128.57. And for with the 8 side it is 135, with the 9 side it is 140, and with the 10 side it is 144. Okay, now the child can calculate and then check out whether the angles are coming properly. Okay. Let us go to the next property about the center of the regular polygon. What do you mean by the center? The meeting point of all perpendicular angle bisectors. Let us go to the angle bisectors now. Here the angle bisectors are here. Or I will go for the angle bisector of these two sides. I got it. I will get the angle bisector of these two sides. I got it. Then angle bisector of these two sides. I got it. Angle bisector of these two sides. I got it. All of them, they meet at a point intersection. Let us take the point of intersection of all these now. It is being coming as K. What we can do is we can hide all these lines except that K. We can hide all this line, this line, this line, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, you can hide it. I think you know how to hide it. You open that algebraic view and then when it is in blue color, just click it and then it will become white color. Therefore, it will get hidden. Okay, then I will come back to the geometry now. Now, K is the midpoint of that one that you can convert it into K or O, whatever may be. When you go for this 4, again that midpoint is midpoint only. This is the center of the polygon, center of the polygon. Okay, the center of the polygon. Okay, well, now another interesting idea about this is from this center, when you just join lines to these vertices, it will have equal length. Let us see it now. Let us go to this segment A and K, then B, K, then C, K. Well, I want all these sides should be equal. Okay, let us see. I will go for this object property. In that basic, you press this value. Press this value. It is coming as 3.24. You show only the value 3.24. Okay, don't go for the polygon. No need for this. Okay, let us go for this one. Again, object property. Don't select the polygon. You can select it from, if you want having some confusion, you go to this graphing. Here, they will be seen here. Okay, F1 3.24. Okay, here you can right click it. Go to the object property and then click value. It is showing now. Is it okay? Label, if you want, don't show the label, then you can show the value at least. Okay, value is shown. Well, good for this H1. Again, object property. Then go and show the value. Go and show the value. Okay. It is showing all 3.24. I will come back to geometry now. Okay. Okay. Now you see, whenever I'm just moving it, 4.14, and from that it is always equal now. Okay. When you move it to here to 4, again the 4.89, 5.89, everywhere it is there. Okay. Now when you go back to that very big pentagon, some of them are not joined now. Now you can join now. This segment you can join now. This segment you can join. This segment you can join. These are all the new segments now. This segment you can join. This segment you can join. Then once again, this segment you can join. This segment you can join, and this segment you can join. Okay, all these are joined from that center. They should be of equal length. Let us see it now from that, go to that algebra now. Now here 11.2 all are shown here. If you go to the graphing, so many 11.2s will be there. Okay, what you have to do is go to the right click, object property, show the value. Again, go for right clicking, object property, show the value. It is also shown there, show the value. Then again, object property, if it is name is there, then convert it into value. Okay, convert it into value. Okay, then again for this J1, again object property, go there, and then you should have some little bit patience. Okay, please be careful, select that value. Then again, object property, go there, and then value. Then go to this L1, object property, then go to its value. Select that value properly. Then again M1, object property, go there, and then select it value. It is not selected. Okay, then go back to this N1, then again object property, then again value. Okay, again value. Again go to this last one, P1, and then again its value. Okay, I'm just closing it over here. Okay, now you see all are showing its value now. What is this geometry we know? Well, you see, all are being shown its value. All are equal from the center. Let us go back to this first one. Okay, just see 444. It is 4.89, 6.92, 9.04, 11.2. Okay, it's all are equal now. And another interesting property about this one is it is being divided into so many isosceles triangles, because these two sides are equal, and therefore all the properties of regular polygon are checked now. Property number one, all the interior angles are equal. All the interior angles are equal when on all the regular polygons, whatever may be the number of sides. And the property of that angle is 2n minus 4 upon n multiplied by 90 degree. That also we have checked. And we have checked about the center of the every regular polygon, center, and from that center all the vertices are of equal distance. That also we have checked. And the line joining the center and the vertices, they divide it into that much number of isosceles triangles. For all the properties of regular pentagons are done here. One more advantage in this is, in this slider right click and then click this animation on. automatically it will go from 3 to 10 and from 10 to 3. Now the children can at any place they can stop it and they can verify the property of that particular polygon. I am just closing this animation. Thank you friends for watching.